I achieve really full and plump lips before and now. No filler. Welcome to today's video. Today is going to be my very first Fab and Five video. This is a series that I'm starting. It's going to be a weekly video that I will upload every Saturday, and it is going to be any beauty related content that you would already find on my channel. If you are new here, I already upload every Monday and Thursday, and this series, Fab and Five, basically going to be us getting fabulous in 5 minutes or less. I'm going to be doing speed reviews, tutorials, quick tips in 5 minutes or less. So if you'd like to find out what we're doing today, and if you're interested in beauty related content in 5 minutes or less, then keep on watching. So today we're going to be talking about how to achieve a full pouty lip naturally. It doesn't matter if you're doing a red lip, if you're doing a purple lip, a pink lip, a nude lip, a blue lip. It's the technique that achieves this look. So I love nude lips. So that's what we're going to be doing today. So I'm gonna get a nude lip liner that is a little bit darker than my actual lipstick. Obviously, it depends on what the shade of your lipstick you're using. What I actually like to do is find my lipstick first and then swatch lip liners beside it to make sure that it's a little bit darker. The lipstick that I'm gonna be using today is Pat McGrath Matte Trance Lipstick in Peep Show. As you can see, it's a beautiful pink nude. I love my Gerard Cosmetics lip liner in Cher. This is one of my absolute favorite lip liners. And as you can see, it is quite a bit darker, but it's still a nude lip liner. So it's not gonna be too contrasting. Still wanna have a shade that's similar enough that they're gonna mesh and mix. It's not too contrasting. So let's just get right down to it. I personally like to overline a little bit, but like you don't need to go like up here to get full lips. If you want to have like that really pouty look, then I would recommend overlining very slightly. Like you will see how little I overline, but it's still gonna make a difference. Okay, so that's the bottom line. Slightly overlined the bottom, but I typically overline the top a bit more, so you will see. As you can see, this side looks quite a bit more full than this side. That's just by overlining the slightest bit. Now in the center of the lip when I'm connecting them, you know how your lips go in at the top? I'm gonna kind of go higher than the actual center. So in doing that, you're actually making it look a little bit more full in the center. So see how it doesn't come down as much? When I come down all the way, it's gonna emphasize how thin those points are at my Cupid's bow. So I wanna round those out. I don't wanna make the whole lip just one line, but a little bit less pointy. I wanna make them more round. What I'm gonna do is take my lip liner. I'm gonna fill in that whole side and that whole side. And then I'm gonna just, as I get to the center, leave more and more room as it gets closer. You leave basically this area right here open, and same on the bottom. The darkest part is the outside, these outer edges. It's gonna make that look smaller, and by bringing it up a little higher and then leaving that area open, it's gonna make that area look fuller. So now we're gonna take that lipstick, which I'm taking Pat McGrath Matte Trance Lipstick in Peep Show. And I'm gonna focus it where I haven't lined. Now, we want the center of our lips to be fullest. So we're gonna fully apply it over top of the lip liner. Now, I'm gonna take it. Remember how we started the lip liner here, filled in the whole lip, and as we got to the center, it was thinner. Now, we're doing the opposite. So we want it to be the most filled in the center, and as we get to the outer part of the lip, it's going to be less of this shade and more of the lip liner, if that makes sense. And you can use your finger to kind of blend the two if you want it to look really like seamless. Do you see the difference of before and now? How much fuller my lips look? No Botox, no filler. And the last step would be to apply a lip gloss because it's going to make your lips look even more plump. The majority of the gloss, I want the emphasis to be in the center. You want to almost make them look less wide and more long to get them more plump. So that's how I achieve really full and plump lips, just naturally. Hope you guys found this helpful and enjoyed my very first Fab and Five. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys next.